And in today's tutorial for Crossplays, we're going to see Zanti 2 from Zimperium, which is the replacement for Disploid, one of the best penetration testing applications for Android. And this is why the developer of Disploid was hired by Zimperium, which makes Zanti 2. So, as you can see, when we open the application, we have the network scanning results. As you can see in my network, I have two connected devices. Let's scan again. As you can see, when we hit this button, we have a new network scan, and we can do the intrusive scan to scan for vulnerabilities. Hit OK. And here is the network gateway or the network router, and then the connected devices appears here after the network gateway, so first of all, if we select the network gateway, we have this options here to scan, to perform an advanced scanning on target, to connect to remote port. As you can see, we have here all the open ports of the network gateway of our network, to check the network gateway for weak passwords, and as you can see here, we have dictionary attacks. We have here all the supported protocols, and if we select the protocol, we can hit go and the cracking starts. So we're not going to do this now. Then we have the man in the middle section, which is a really good one. It starts with this button here. Sorry for this. It starts, and in the first section here, if we hit view, we can find all the session that has been captured from the victim. In the second section, we can see all the logged images that we captured from the victim again, and in the third section, we can edit all the packets, and we can modify each individual HTTP request and make our own requests. So here we can see that they are two different man-in-the-middle attacks, the ARP poisoning and the ICMP attack. Of course, we have SSL strip option here. We can turn it off, but it's useless than the man-in-the-middle attack. We can redirect the HTTP requests to our IP or every other IP that we want. Here, as you can see, we can replace images with our own image. Everything we want, as you can see here, we can select an image and then replace it with every image in the victim's machine. We can capture the download files that the victim downloads, and we can intercept download with a specified file that we want. And finally, we can insert specified HTML code into victim's web pages with this final option. Let's go back, and as you can see, we have these two options that we can check the target for shell shock or SSL poodle vulnerabilities. They are really good options. So let's go back, and as you can see here now, in the first and main page, we have the network gateway here, another connected host that uses Windows, and we have its MAC address, its network controller name, and its PC name, and all the open ports. We have this device with its MAC address and the Android operating system here. And if we hit one of these, we can see the same options as the network gateway we saw earlier. If we swipe right, we can see the Nmap scan results here. And if we swipe left, we can fill our own comment for this host. If we go back and hit the Xanti icon up here, we have some other options. First of all, we have the MAC changer that helps us change our MAC and be a little stealthier than earlier. The Zetether option that we can make a wireless access point and give internet with our Wi-Fi, our 3G connectivity or 4G connectivity, and then perform man-in-the-middle attacks into the victim. Of course, this with this we have not to be connected in any network. Then we have the all-known routerpwn.com that gives us many vulnerabilities for many known routers and modem routers out there. Many vulnerabilities, and as you can see, we have cloud reports for the premium Xanti installation. We have Wi-Fi monitor. As you can see, all the near Wi-Fi networks is here with their safety protocol, WPA2, as you can see here, the MAC address, the channel that they are using, and the network strength. And then we can make an HTTP server, and that's it. We have settings down there. As you can see, it is a really powerful application. We can do many things, and believe me, the man-in-the-middle attacks works very well. It is a really powerful application. So let's close this. Okay, and if we want finally to connect to a remote port, as you can see, it gets us to Google Play Store to download the Connect Bot and connect to the remote port with an SSH client, as an SSH client. Okay, so this was it. This was Xanti, the replacement for Disploit. Of course, everything you saw in this video is for educational purposes only, so please operate carefully and in your own property. I do not bring any responsibility in what happens to you if you act irresponsibly. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel and like my videos. Thank you.